All right, welcome. This is not 10.3, as it says here. A couple of the students were wanting extra examples of two-column proofs. So this is kind of supplementary, going over some of these two-column proofs so you can feel more comfortable. On the test, there will be some of those on the test, and it would be beneficial to know how to do those and feel comfortable with those. So I'm going to go over quite a few of these. I would suggest pausing for every problem, trying to do it yourself, and then click play and see if you did it right. Okay, and if you did it right, awesome. If you didn't, learn from your mistakes and make sure you feel comfortable doing these for the test. Okay. Right here I have the three theorems that we're using. You'll only be using one for each. Angle. So if you have two triangles where they give you angles, or they may not even give you numbers for it, they might just give you something like from number one, that would be an angle. Okay. They may give you side, angle, side. So if there's two sides, if they give you two sides for each triangle, then you'd be using side, angle, side. If they give you three sides, then you would be using side, side, side. Okay? And sometimes you have choices. So I'll go over one of the problems where you could have chosen one or the other. Okay? So before we get into this quickly, let's quickly do, just state what theorem we would use. So for example, one, they give a side, angle, side for both of them. Oops, side, angle, side. So you would want to be using side, angle, side. Okay, and I kind of have this set up so that all of the side, angle, sides would be by each other, so we can go over different types of side, angle, sides. So, for example, this one as well, this would be a side, angle, side, and we'll talk about that. So the first thing you'd want to do is write down what you're looking for. Okay? All right, so we'd want you to write our two column. This is our statement. What do we know? Statement. And our reason. So our statement is what we know, and reason is how we know it. Okay, so our statement for this one, you don't have to start at a specific location. If you wanted to do the side kind of things first, that would be fine. Or you can start with your angles. There are congruent angles. So for example, the first thing you could write down is angle U is congruent to angle A. And the reason, it's given. Okay. All right, we didn't have to do any extra work. It's just given. All right, next we'd want to do something. Since we're doing side, angle, side, we did our angles. Now we need to do our sides, okay? So if these are similar triangles, the corresponding sides need to be proportional. Okay, so we would need to make sure that I like to do the numbers first. So if we did 196 and the corresponding side here would be 70, okay, that should be equal to the corresponding side for the other side of those triangles. So 126 divided by 45. All right, and you may say, Mr. Warner, how do we know that we go from here to here? How do we know we don't go to 45? Okay, so how we make sure is I always choose, sorry, let me clear this up a little bit. Always choose the largest for both triangles, okay? They're both the largest, okay? And then the next one would be our next largest, okay? That will always make sure that we're doing the corresponding sides that are correct, Okay, so 196 corresponds to 70, and 126 corresponds to 45. Okay, and you would want to simplify that. Let me get my calculator out. So we'll do 196 divided by 70. Okay, and you could simplify that as a fraction or as a decimal. So here, I'm just going to write it as a decimal, 2.8. And then this should also be the same, 126 divided by 45. And what do you know? It's also 2.8. Okay, so we know that they are proportional. We need to write this in our statement. We need to say that side UV is proportional to BA, and that is equal to our next one for 126, which is UW corresponds to CA. Okay? The order of those letters don't matter. Those can be switched around, okay? But you just want to match what goes with what, okay? And you'll be fine, okay? So now we have our statements for our angles and our sides, both sides, that they're proportional. Now all we need to do is finally restate our similarity statement, okay? So triangle UVW, which is right here already, and you could write it like that as well, and then just put an arrow over. Triangle UVW similar to triangle, and then we need to make sure that we do this right. So UV, let me change my color, so UV, so we go from U to V, that corresponds to A to B, okay? A to B. And then after that, you could just continue over. So if we go this way, then we can just continue going this way. So we don't, I guess that's our only other choice, would go to W, and so this would also go from to C, right? And again, if we had these switched around, this kind of tells us what it has to be, which is nice. So we don't have to worry about, Does that make sense? Hope so. Okay, and then all we'd say is by side angle side. Right? Let's do another one. Hopefully that wasn't too bad. Okay, pause if you can. Okay, if not, just watch again. So this will be our statement and our reasoning. Okay, again, this is also going to be a side angle side. That doesn't show anything with the angles, but we are sharing this same angle. So triangle EFG uses the same angle as ELK. Okay, so we know that angle GEF is congruent to angle, LEK. Okay, and how do we know that? Our reasoning is by the reflexive property. Okay, reflexive property is when they share the same angle. So you may want to remember that. Okay? Reflexive property shares. Oops, that's not how you do it. Shares same angle. Okay? Now we need to do the same thing with the sides. We need to make sure that corresponding sides are proportional. Okay, so for our small triangle, that corresponds to the long triangle, or the big triangle, okay, and that would be 26. So we could say that 13 divided by 26, or you could do opposite. You could do 26 divided by 13. Okay, and that should be also equal to 11 divided by 22. As you find out, you get 0.5 for both of them, and you're good. So you need to write down those letters as well. So 13, that corresponds to EL, and 26 corresponds to EG. And that should be equal to 11 corresponds to EK. Divide that by EF. Okay, they should all have like little lines on top. Okay, and then we're done with that, so we can write down our similarity statement. So triangle EFG, which is what they give here, and we need to say that's similar to triangle. Okay, we do the same thing. So we'd go EFG, okay, and then we'll go EKL. Okay, by side angle side. Right? All right, next one. So feel free, this is another side angle side. If you have any questions or if you know what you're doing, pause and see if you can do it by yourself. Okay, so first thing first, statement and reason. Okay, one thing we know is we know that angle GSF, this angle, is congruent to angle UST, and this is by vertical lines. Okay, so if you have two lines that cross each other, like here, we have this line and this line that cross. Let us know that these two angles are the same angle, or they're congruent. Okay? Check with that, all right? Next, we need to find that our corresponding sides are proportional. So I always like to choose my largest, and it goes to its largest. And then its next largest to its next largest. Okay? So let's check. 36 divided by 11. Is that equal to 21 divided by 7? All right. And I know already if we do 36 divided by 11, that gives us 3.27. But if we go 21 divided by 7, that gives us 3. So these are not equal to each other. And here you would say not similar. Okay, so there's a non-example, and there may be one of those as well in the test, so be prepared for both. Okay, next, this is one that's basically the same one. Let's see if that all works out. So let's make this two-column proof, statement and reason. Okay, we do the same sort of thing, so SUR is congruent to angle WUV, and we know that the reason is by vertical angles. We know that these are congruent. Okay, and then we do the same thing. So choose the largest and it's the other triangle's largest. So 55 divided by 11. That should be equal to 30 divided by 6. Okay, 55 divided by 11 is 5. And 30 divided by 6 is also 5. Okay, so perfect. Right now we know that they are similar. We just need to write down this statement. So 55 corresponds to the U or UV. Doesn't matter. And then 11 corresponds to UR. And that should be equal to line or the side that has a length of 30 is UW, and it corresponds to US. Okay, put these lines on top. Okay, that would tell us that the segment. And then all we need left to do is write down our similarity statement. So triangle UV. W, okay, UV, that corresponds with UR, so we'll do triangle UVW corresponds to triangle UR, and then we just need the last letter, so it goes from UVW, UVW, URS by side angle side. Okay, so those are all my examples for side angle side. Sorry, come on. All right, here we go. Now let's look at this. What type of theorem are we going to use? They don't give us any sides. So if they don't give us any sides, it's always going to be by angle angle. Okay, so let's make our statement and our reason, okay? And there's basically two ways you could do this, okay? This angle right here, we've kind of talked about this before, this type of angle is a reflexive property. They share the same angle. We can use that, okay? And then, since they tell us that these are parallel, we know that these angles are congruent, and these two angles are congruent. Okay, so we only need two of them. So if you wanted to do using these types of angles, and we would never have to use reflexive property, that would be fine. Okay, but either way, we need to write down that these two lines are parallel. So ML is parallel to RQ, and that is given. Okay, after that, if you want to use these two angles and these two angles, I'll go ahead and do that. When we have those two parallel lines and we have a transversal, so this is like a transversal, goes through two parallel lines. When we have that, we can just say that angle R is congruent to angle M by complementary angles. They are complementary angles. Okay, and it would be the same with angle L is congruent to angle Q by the same reasoning. Okay, so I put these little quotes that means that it's exactly the same as what's above. Okay, you could be done with that, or another way would be use the reflexive property, okay? You'd use one of the complementary angles and reflexive property, okay? After that, you would be able to write down our similarity statement. So let me clear this out a little bit. Yeah, I want to keep that part in case you wanted to use the reflexive property. Okay, so here, P to Q, that corresponds to P to L, P, L, and then M. Okay, so we can just put this here, and then we could say by angle, angle. All right, next one here, they don't give us any numbers, but that's just fine. This angle corresponds to this angle, and this angle corresponds to this angle. Okay, so we could write our statement and our reasoning that angle U is congruent to angle C, and that's given. And angle T is congruent to angle D, and that is also given. Okay, and so we just write down our statement that CDE, CDE corresponds to UTS by angle, angle. Okay. All right. Let's give this one a shot as well. Okay. All right. So here, again, this is going to be angle, angle. They don't give any of the side or the lengths of the triangles. So this is also going to be angle, angle. Okay, we'll write down our statement and our reasoning. Okay, we know they give us that these are equal or are congruent. So let's just write that down. Angle U is congruent to angle G, and that's given. All right. And then whether or not we can say that this angle is congruent or not, we can for sure say that these two angles are congruent. So angle UTV. Let's do it a little different. You can do it any way you want, but let's start at T. We'll go T, and then we'll go to U, to where it has the double angle, double sign thingy, and to V, that is congruent to angle, and we'll start at T and go to TGF, okay? And that is by vertical angles. Okay? So we have our two angles, and then we just write down our statement, all of this, and put it in here. Triangle TUV is similar to triangle, so TUV and TGF by angle, angle. Okay, next one, it's a little different. All right, so if we did this, we'd have our statement and our reasoning, okay? You may want to write this down, that angle GFH is congruent to angle, I always run out of space, RFQ, and that is by vertical angles. Okay, now we need to find one more angle. Okay, if you wanted to, you could figure out what this angle actually is. You could do 180 minus 42 minus 55. 180 minus, because a triangle gives us a total of 180 degrees. 42 minus 55, and then it gives us 83, so this would also be 83. And then if we wanted to, we could find out what this angle is. So don't have to do this, but this would be 56. So as you look at this, we'd find that we don't have another set of congruent angles. Okay, closest would be 56 and 55, but that doesn't count. Close doesn't count, okay? So here we'd say not similar. right? I think we had one kind of like that on the homework, except we didn't have to do a two-column proof. Or sometimes they've also been problems where they've been like, instead of having numbers, they had like a one thing here, and then they did two here, and then three here. Okay, same sort of situation. This would have to be like five or four. So we wouldn't have any corresponding or congruent angles pairing. Okay. All right, so those are the angles. And last but not least, side. Side is when they give us all three sides for both triangles. Okay, if they don't give us all three, then we can't use side. All right, so statement, reason, okay. Again, I always like to start with the largest, and that corresponds to the other's largest, okay. So it's kind of like what we did before with side, with our two sides, except now we don't need any angles. We just need three sets of corresponding sides. So, for example, we could do 39 divided by 26. That should be equal to our next largest, would be 30 and 20. And then the next would be 28 and 18. Okay, so we would plug that in our calculator. 39 divided by 26, that gives us 3/2. And then this is also 3/2. And then plug that in, 28 divided by 18. Is that what it says? 28 divided by 18. And that is not, that's 14/9. Oops, 14/9. Which is not similar. Okay. Let me just make sure that's right. Okay. So double check your answers. Make sure you're finding the right thing. But yep, not similar. Okay. Next one. Perhaps this one will work. Okay, but you do the same thing. Statement, reason, okay, largest to largest, okay, these would be the two largest. Okay, you can go either way you want. You could go 36 divided by 9, or you can do 9 divided by 36. 36 divided by 9 is 4, okay, and then we can go next largest, 8 to 28, okay, that is also 4. And then 7 and 32. I guess that's not in order. I did that wrong. I'm sorry. 8. Not 28. Sorry. 8 to 32. Okay, so 32 divided by 8. That is also 4. And then 28 and divided by 7 is also 4. Okay, so we have we have three sets of corresponding sides. Okay, so we'd write those letters as well. So we'd still need to do this kind of stuff where we have our. So if we did 36 on the top, that would be like KL. That corresponds to EF. And then next was 32, which is like LJ, and LJ corresponds to FD. And then last one would be like KJ and ED. And then we'd write our triangle similarity, our statement, JKL is similar to triangle JKL. D, E, F. By, side, side, side. Okay, so those are, I feel like side, side, side is the easiest. Okay, this one, they give you three sides for both triangles, but they also share the same angle. So if you wanted to solve this, you could do it by side, angle, side, or you could do it by side, side, side. Okay, so statement, reason. Here, if we're going to do side, 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 we do the same sort of thing. This corresponds to this. This corresponds to the smaller triangle here, which we don't know yet, but 96 divided by, or minus 84 gives us 12, okay? And then large triangle to small triangle, right? So let's see if this all works out. 96 divided by 12 should be equal to 64 divided by 8, which should also be equal to 56 divided by 7. Okay, 76 divided by 12, that gives us 8. This gives us 8, and this gives us 8. So we're all good to go for side, side, side. All right, you just need to write down the letters. Okay, so 96 corresponds, or is TS and TF. And then for 64, SR and FE. And then 56 is TR and 7 is TE. And you just do triangle TSR is similar to triangle TFE by side, side, side. All right. If you wanted to do it the other way, you would maybe use these two, bring those down, and then you would say triangle or angle FTE is congruent to angle STR, and that is the reflexive property. And then you would write the same, this thing, or not that whole thing. You would take this back, right? This would go back down here, and we'd say by side, angle, side. Okay. Okay. All right, so those two ways, you don't need to do both. You would just choose one of them. I would probably choose side, side, side. All right, so hope that was helpful. If not, please come get help. All right. I'm going to leave this. This was like your homework that was on there as well. So I think I will just go and do these really quick. I won't talk at all. But if you didn't do the homework, then this could be another help, okay? All right. Or maybe I will talk a little bit, okay? So here, these are parallel. We have two parallel lines. CB is parallel to TS, and that's given, okay? And that's important to know. Actually, this is a good example. We haven't did one of these. Okay. Since these are parallel, we know that this is a transversal, which means we know that this angle and these two angles are congruent. Okay. And that is, we know that by the alternate interior angles. Okay, and we could use this as another alternate interior angles, or you could do this angle as vertical angles. So you only need to have two. Okay, I'm just doing another example of not doing a vertical angle. So I'll just do angle CAB B is congruent to angle SAT by vertical angles. Vertical angles. Okay. And then we'd write this triangle thingy down here. Triangle ABC. ABC corresponds to ATS. Remember, that needs to be in the right order, okay? And we'd say by angle, angle. Okay? I think the vacuum person's coming. I will turn it off if they come, okay? The next one, I kind of went over this in class, I think. So here, side, angle side for both of these. Okay, we'd know that our statement would be that angle C is congruent to angle U, and that's given. And then we'd need to do largest to largest. So 42 divided by 14. It's okay if you flip it over as long as you are consistent. Okay, so if you go from 42 to here, then you need to go from 33 to 11. Okay, so 42 divided by 14, that gives us 3, and that also gives us 3. So we're all set. Just need to write down these letters. So 42 is UW. It corresponds to CA. And then for 33 is UV, and 11 corresponds to CB. Okay, and then we'd rewrite this over here, and we'd do triangle UVW corresponds to CBA by side angle side. Okay, here's another one. This is basically what we did most recently. So maybe I'll go to 13 really quick. Okay, statement, reasoning. These are given. These angles are congruent. So angle A is congruent to angle E, and that's given. And then angle B is congruent to angle F, and that's given. So it'd say triangle EFG is congruent to EFG ABC by angle angle. Okay? All right. Well, thanks for watching, and hopefully that helps. Again, feel free to come and talk to me. Okay, see you guys.